Ravens, let's see, they're favorites in the division, right? They're leading the division, but they are underdogs in Cleveland this week. These two teams played just a couple weeks ago. Baltimore is banged up. We know that. So how do you feel here about the 3-point spread?
I wish I could have a better insight about the Ravens' injuries. Like, they're just, it's so many players that it's really hard to quantify, and different coaches are just, they have different levels of capability at making up for the fact that certain guys are not playing at full strength or out or whatever. What I do feel like is true, though, regardless of how injured some of these Ravens guys are, is that everything is baked into this line. Like, if the Ravens were at full strength, there's absolutely no way that they're getting a full field goal in Cleveland. I think the Ravens would be a much better team if everyone's healthy and Lamar's kind of playing normal. So it does seem like all of that information is already baked in to the point where, like, it doesn't seem plausible that there's more value on the Browns at -3. But it's not like I'm excited to take the Ravens here either, because I'm just kind of worried about this team. They clearly have been struggling over most of the season, actually. So overall, I think it's probably a fairish line, but like, I just have very little confidence in predicting what's going to happen in this game.
You think this spread read is too high or too low? So like, too long, too short?
Yeah, I mean, I'll say from this standpoint, like, I'm with Matt. I'm not really knowing what the Ravens are doing, and they lose Marlon Humphreys as well, right? This team has just been absolutely riddled with injuries from the start in the preseason. But I will say this, though, and why I think Cleveland, this line is a little bit too it's just too high for Cleveland, right? I think the swing is just too much. Remember, 2 weeks ago, before Cleveland went on their bye, they played Baltimore, and now we're having a 5-point swing, 5.5 or 6-point swing, wherever this spread lands, towards Cleveland. Do we really think that Baker Mayfield and all of his injuries, with no receiver, and we talked about this yesterday with David Njoku being their best receiver now out, do we really think that this team is a 6-point swing, right? Just because they went on a bye, they didn't play, and the Ravens are playing, you know, like, under expectation? I don't think so. So I'll side with the Ravens on this one, but I'm with Matt here, and like, I have no idea what's going to happen in this game, because we've seen Lamar throw 4 interceptions, and we've also seen him go for 300 yards and, you know, run for 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, and you know his legs will probably be a huge factor in this one, Pearson. The Ravens have not been good in their recent road games either. 2-5 ATS in their last 7 road games.
It's too high, and I'm by no means a Ravens fan. I believe they're a pretty fraudulent team. They're a bad team. But you know what? Just because they don't win with style points, they're not consistent. But when it comes to converting on specific third downs, when it comes to getting off the field when they need to get off the field, or getting points when they need them, or preventing points, they seem to get it done, and that's what their record says. And there's a reason why they're leading the division. They win these games when they shouldn't. But yet, I think they're still going to pull this off. Lamar Jackson will get the plays when he needs to get the plays. And just to reiterate the point, we don't really know what to expect in terms of injuries from the Ravens. They put 15 guys on the injury report last week, and most of them suited up. We do know that they've lost Marlon Humphrey, and that's a pretty big loss in secondary. But then again, their secondary wasn't that great with him last season. Their secondary hasn't been that great with him this season. He's one of the best cornerbacks, but that really hasn't translated. They're still allowing a lot of big plays. They're missing tackles. But with all these things that we're saying about him being inconsistent, the defense being inconsistent, they still win games. I think they can win this thing outright.